Hi guys, this is GSN.com and I'm here with one of the most awaited phones of the summer, the Realme GT 5G. It's inspired by the 4GT. It's just as fast in the world of smartphones as the 4GT is in the world of race cars. So you can see that in the design, the inspiration from race cars. This is supposed to be a gaming phone on a pretty decent price range. I wouldn't call it budget, but still, it's rather okay for basically anyone's pocket. And that's what I was talking about. The inspiration from racing cars is here at the backside. This is what they call a racing stripe. It looks beautiful with this yellow backside, which has a texture which imitates leather. This is no slouch. It has a Snapdragon 888 processor inside. It has a 120Hz refresh rate. And let's see what's inside the box. Okay, so first things first, the Realme GT 5G was just unveiled. It's starting to reach the world this month, June. This is the promise, or better said, the welcome. Hey, welcome to the Realme family. We've been testing quite a few Realme phones lately. The Poco M3 is a budget phone. The Poco F3 was a bit of a surprise because it has a very powerful processor. And also, we got the Poco X3 Pro with a powerful processor and the Poco X3, which broke some price barriers. Now, back to the Realme GT 5G. Here's the key used to access the slots. I'm talking about the SIM slots because there's no microSD here. You're going to have to deal with the onboard storage. Here you can find a quick guide. Also, important information guide. And of course, a case used to protect this beautiful device. Then there's this cable which goes from USB-C to USB-C. It's a bit beefier than usual. For good reason, it's meant to transmit enough power for 65 watt charging via this charger here. If you look closely, you're going to see here that it goes all the way to 65 watts, which is pretty mind-blowing. Okay, so aside from that, this is the actual device. It feels lighter than expected. I would go ahead and dare to say that it's possibly one of the comfiest Snapdragon 888 phones I've played with recently, and I've played with quite a few. The backside really feels like leather and adds to the grip. We have here a beautiful logo, Realme, which shines just like the black bar of the backside. What else we could mention here? Aside from this gold and black combo, you can find the phone in blue or silver. Now, aside from all these accessories, you should know that the phone measures 8.4 millimeters in thickness and weighs 186 grams. You can see here on the left side that we have the volume buttons and the SIM tray, while on the right side we have only the power button with a golden accent. At the bottom side, you can find the USB-C on a glossy frame, a microphone and audio jack, and one of the speakers. We have a stereo setup here, and I'm guessing the one at the top is the earpiece because we don't have a separate one, as some Xiaomi phones do. Here's the microphone. Another one, as DJ Khaled would say. Now, as far as the screen is concerned, it's definitely top-notch, 6.43 inch, which is considered compact nowadays. Super AMOLED, 120Hz refresh rate with a resolution of 2400x1080 pixels. It's a 20:9 aspect, and we got here a punch hole for the selfie camera and also an embedded optical fingerprint scanner. It's in the screen here and should let you unlock the device properly, even though I've set up the face unlock because I feel it's a bit faster. We have already applied from the factory a screen protector, just in case you were wondering, and I've also installed a few applications to show you what's available on the hardware front. First of all, Qualcomm Snapdragon 888. Doesn't get more powerful than this on Android. 5 nanometer processor, accompanied in this case, let's see. We've got 8 gigs of RAM and 128 gigabytes of storage. We're dealing with LPDDR5 and UFS 3.1, the best of the best. There are also versions with 12 gigs of RAM and double the amount of storage. Once again, no microSD here, in case you were wondering. At least we have an audio jack, so there's that. You can see it here. As far as the battery is concerned, it's a 4500 mAh charging at 65 watts. It promises to juice up in just 35 minutes, and when I say juice up, I mean go from 0 to 100%. I guess we'll have to wait and see. We continue with stereo speakers, and a 16 megapixel camera here, which I have reason to think should be similar with the one from the Realme 8 series. Now, this is the front camera, 16 megapixels. If you go to the back, we have a triple setup. You can see here the promise of a 64 megapixel triple camera. The main cam is obviously a 64 megapixel one. The good news is that we're using a Sony sensor, not a Samsung one, and that already bumps it up in quality. It's actually Sony IMX682, in case you're wondering. It's accompanied by an 8 megapixel ultra wide and 2 megapixel macro camera, dual LED, dual tone flash, and 4K 60 frames per second capture, plus a bunch of options which you may find useful in this camera area. So first of all, you have photo with AI features, AI scene enhancement. Then you pull this for some extra frame and timer options. You got your night mode with a special extra AI feature and a pro nightscape, which lets you tweak white balance, shutter, ISO, and focus. This is the video section where we have AI as well, AI highlight video. You have a special stabilization option, ultra steady, and you can choose the resolution. You can switch from full HD to 4K and keep the 60 frames per second or go with 30. Photo with quite the few levels of zoom, portrait with its own bokeh feature, 64 megapixel, and more, where you can find slow-mo, pro or expert, ultra macro, dual view, movie and text scanner. And that's pretty much it. Didn't forget about the connectivity. This little bundle of joy offers you 4G and 5G as well. It even offers you Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5.2 with the useful aptX HD. There's GPS dual band, there's NFC for payments. You can see it right here. We got also USB-C 2.0, and we're running on Android 11 with Realme UI 2.0 on top. Now, there's an interesting feature which Realme promoted, the combo of Wi-Fi and 5G. They can be combined together for a faster experience, and we also have 360Hz sampling rate for gamers. Another thing I haven't seen before on other smartphones is the stainless steel vapor cooling chamber, which is a new mechanism. It's usually copper, so there's that. I'm going to discover this beast as the days go by. It's definitely a gaming phone with a special Hyper Boost 4.0 technology, which allocates more memory to your games. I'm pretty sure we also have some gaming features here and there if I really look into it. Let's actually check it out. I don't see much bloater installed, so that's good news. I still have the Soul Loop app, which lets you create a collage of photos and videos. I see you have a music player. I've installed a bunch of benchmarks and I've obtained quite impressive results. Okay, so that's pretty much it. At first sight, I will be looking for the extra options. I see there are some extras here for gestures. I'll be back with a full review pretty soon. This has been the introduction and unboxing of the Realme GT 5G. Definitely the fourth GT of smartphones and priced at only $500. This is it from us, gsnrom.com. Bye-bye.